The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel 2010 In-Depth, Chapter 13, Loan Payments. Well, hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. The example from Chapter 13 in the Excel In-Depth book is talking about how to discover new functions. All right, so I want to create a loan payment calculator. I have a price, maybe a car, $25,995, pay for it over 60 months, 5.25% interest. I need to figure out what the monthly payment is going to be. So when you don't know what function to use, you come here to the left of the formula bar and use this tiny little script letter FX. You'll also see that it's here on the formulas tab in a large version, and then in most of the other drop downs here at the bottom. So it's about 13 different places. You can tell that Microsoft really likes this icon. And what you do here is you type what you're trying to figure out. So I'm trying to figure out a loan payment. Click go, and they shortlist the 400 plus functions down to just the functions related to loan payments. Now in this case, the first one, PMT, calculates the payment for a loan based on constant payments and a constant interest rate. That's the one that I want. So I click OK, and they very nicely now take me through step by step rate, interest rate per period for the loan. For example, use 6% divided by 4 for quarterly payments. Okay, well, we have monthly payments, so I need to take the rate field, which is B3, and then type divided by 12, and they even show me what that intermediate result is, 0.004375. I don't particularly care in this case. All right, next one is NPAIR, and hey, by the way, notice that three of these functions are bold. The other two are not bold. That means the top three are required to make the function work. The other two have optional information. So NPAIR, total number of payments for the loan. Okay, well, that's my term. And then PV, that's the present value. In other words, the price of the car. And since this is money coming out of the bank, we are going to type a minus sign and then click on the price of the car. If you didn't do that, the payment would show up as minus, negative, as in it's money leaving your wallet. Okay, so as soon as we get those bold arguments done, we have an answer here, 493, sounds about right. Click OK, and we now have our loan payment. Of course, then if you want to start to do some what-if analysis, you know, what if I get a 48-month loan, or, you know, different price of the car, different interest rate, you can do all kinds of great what-if analysis once you get the formula set up. All right, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.